So good morning everyone, I am Mukunda Dave, assistant professor from mechanical engineering. Today I am dealing with dynamics of machinery. So as you know, for any state of body, dynamics which includes the effect of forces. So if I consider a force which includes the weight of the body plus we are having some inertia force Fi, plus we are having some centrifugal force. For any object we are having some centrifugal force, which I can have it as Fc, and I can have Ff, frictional force, and it continues. So for a dynamics, as we know the definition, it's nothing but a study of mechanism or a mechanics which we are considering the effect or the influence of external forces which are acting on a body. So in coming to the order for your syllabus, we can discuss about something about effect of friction on a body. So friction is a force which resists a body to move. Means when we are having a movement between any two bodies which rubs. So for the more area of contact, the friction is more. So I can say F is directly proportional to area. So if the friction is more, if the area is more, the friction is more. So for an example, I am having a surface, or I can say on a road, if I have a wheel which will slide more faster if I have any block. So for example, if you push any block, it will take more time if you roll any wheel or any circular object, because the area of contact of any circular object is less compared to the area of contact for a square body. So the friction which is directly proportional to the contact of area of the body. So here the friction is, we have been defined now. So the definition of friction is nothing but, we can say, for any movement of the body, the resistance of movement with respect to one another is known as friction. Okay, next comes the classification of friction. So in classification, I will bifurcate it as static friction, dynamic friction, third one is fluid friction. So as we know, what do you mean by static? Static nothing but a body is at rest. So when a body is at rest, the friction which we are having, which we are considering, is known as static friction. And second one is dynamics. As I said, dynamics with influence of forces. So here, in this dynamic force, we are having sliding and rolling. So as I have been given an examples, so if you consider any square objects or a flat based objects, those will slide. So the force or the friction influence due to the sliding of an object is known as sliding friction. And rolling nothing but where the area of contact is less, so the friction is less. The example is a wheel or a vehicle which is moving on a road. So we are having a circular object, a wheel, where the less friction, it is known as rolling friction. Okay, in third one, we are having fluid friction. It is quite technically, so if I consider any fluid, so we are having two types of friction. One is of greasy friction, or I can say non-viscous. So where we don't found any viscous. And second one is fluid friction. I can rename it as film friction, where even I can write it as viscous. So the greasy friction is non-viscous and film friction is viscous. So how to know these two? Greasy friction is nothing but when we are having a friction with a boundary. So an IC engine where I am having a piston, so it is a cylinder head. So where it is connecting rod, crank, and the setup piston. Okay. So within this setup, see the piston, for having a friction, so along with boundary, so I can rename it as boundary friction. So along with boundary, considering viscous effect to the body within the lubrication, within the fluid, so considering the boundary, non-viscous friction happens. Okay, in fluid, if I have any fluid layers, so a better example is oil and water. So where we are having a non-viscous film of those two liquids, where we are having a friction known as film friction, or we can say fluid friction. So these are the classifications. So static, dynamic and fluid. In dynamic we are having sliding and rolling. In fluid friction we are having VC and film. Our VC friction is also known as a boundary friction. So these are the classifications what we can have this friction. And while studying, so for a friction, when it is moving on a surface, we are having two concepts. One is limiting angle, second one is angle of repose. First one is limiting angle, second one is angle of repose. So in general we are denoting these two as, limiting angle is known as, we are denoting it as phi, and angle of repose by means of alpha. Okay, so I will consider the limiting angle. So limiting of friction. So I will consider a surface on which I am having a body which is having a sliding motion. Okay, so this is the body which is having a motion on this surface. Okay, so just I will consider the self weight of the body. So W is the weight which is that, and of course W which acts downwards, while having a normal force, normal reaction, or an opposite to the self weight W. Okay, and with considering these two, definitely I will be having a reaction, means there will be slight change with the body. So body should have to change the position, so that position of the body is known as reaction. So reaction due to the self weight of the body. So this is reaction normal to the force acting, nothing but here we are considered self weight. So the reaction which the body would have been displaced, this will be with an angle of phi. So this phi is known as limiting angle. So you can say, you can ask where the friction comes here. So always friction acts in the opposite direction. So even I will explain in terms of loss of static friction. So this is the friction F which acts on the body. So we have been clear, I think, with the limiting friction, limiting angle. So limiting angle is the change of position or the reaction of the body when it is applied on any load. So here I am having considered self load which is WRMG. So the angle displacement due to the self load with the reaction, the angle is known as phi, or we can say it as limiting angle. Okay, so for angle of repose, for angle of repose I will consider a condition so that the same body, the object which is having an inclined surface, so instead of a flat surface, so see here, this is the surface where we are having an object which is sliding, or I can say which is moving. Okay, the same object which is moving in downward direction. So here it is the W and here it is the RM, and as I said, we are having a reaction force R with an angle of phi. Okay, so the angle with respect to the inclined surface of a sliding object, I name it as alpha, which is nothing but angle of repose. So I repeat, the angle which is concluded, or the angle with respect to the inclined surface is alpha, which is known as angle of repose. Okay, so this is about the limiting angle and angle of repose. In next class, we can discuss about the loss of static friction. Thank you, Ananda.